This video will explain some of the basic configuration settings which can be adjusted to configure the ScanStation P40 for daily work. Once configured, these settings normally don't need to be changed very often. Another video will explain the actual scan parameters, such as field of view or resolution. All settings are changed in the four submenus of the configuration menu. Most settings are obvious. In this video, we will focus on the most useful or less obvious. Use units and formats to select distance units, as well as units for temperature and pressure. Be aware that the correct temperature and pressure should be entered, as these are used later to compute the atmospheric distance corrections. In the date and time menu, the local date and time of the instruments can be set. The entered date and time are then used in all scans, images, log files, and file names. The settings menu offers a bunch of general settings to define the instrument's behavior. We will take a closer look at these settings in the next chapter of this video. And in the language menu, the language for the user interface can be selected. This will also be explained later in this video. In the settings submenu of the configuration menu, all general instrument settings are listed. With the first option, handle check before scan enabled, a quick distance measurement is made in the zenith direction prior to each scan or image acquisition being started. When the handle on top of the instrument is detected, a warning message informs to remove this handle. This is a useful reminder when scanning ceilings or overhead installations, as a mounted handle would be an obstacle in the scan and would hide the area of interest. The next setting, Open Scan Viewer After Scan, defines what happens after a scan has been finished. When it is enabled, the scan viewer will open after each scan. When it is disabled, the scan viewer will not open, but the scan parameter screen opens directly after a scan has finished. More details about the scan viewer will be covered in a separate video. Fan cooling is enabled by default after each scanner start. When we disable it, the internal cooling ventilator is switched off until the internal sensors detect a maximum internal temperature and automatically switch the fan on again. Switching off fan cooling is useful when scanning in dusty environments with lots of particles in the air. The setting for the guiding beam is disabled by default after each scanner start. Enabled, it provides a visible red laser as a guiding beam to show the current direction of the invisible measuring laser beam. The last setting, switch on by power, controls the automatic booting of the instrument when it is connected to any power source. When switched on, the scanner boots up as soon as an internal battery or any external power source is connected. When switched off, the silver on-off button must be pressed to start the scanner. With the key combination Shift-Reset, all the settings in this screen are set back to their default values. Once we are okay with the settings, we can confirm them with the Cont button and return to the configuration menu. In the language submenu in the configuration menu, we can select the required language from a drop-down list. By default, English is installed and is the only language provided in this list, but a lot of other languages can be added by separate language files. These can be downloaded from the Leica My World portal, so let's have a look how this is done. Access Leica My World with your personal account by entering your email address and password. Then in the upper right corner, open the My Applications list and select My Downloads. In the list of product categories, search for HDS laser scanners, and finally select ScanStation P30/40 from the list of all HDS scanners. Within the download options, select software, and then search for the section ScanStation P-Series Language Files. At the right-hand side is a list of all available language files. In this example, we opt for the German language file and download it. Copy the file, which has the extension .lng, to the main directory of a USB memory device and attach the USB stick to the scanner. Once the USB stick is recognized by the scanner, a USB icon pops up in the status bar of the user interface. Now we can go to Tools, Transfer, System Files. In the Languages tab, a drop-down list now offers all the language files found on the USB stick. In this example, the German language file is available to upload. After pressing the Cont button, a confirmation screen opens and we confirm with a Yes to directly upload and activate the German language for the user interface. The system now returns to the main menu and all text is offered in German, but icons and graphics do not change. We have seen in this video how to configure the scanner for its first usage after delivery. From the configuration menu, we can configure the units and formats, date and time, some general settings of the instrument, and the system language. Now we are ready to start a first project with the instrument. Thanks for watching the video.